Hi, welcome back to my channel, Your Canadian Blind Girl. I'm Ashley. I realized in my other videos that I did not ever say my name. And today I am working with a special guest. We are collaborating. And her name, or her YouTube channel name, is Amanda Jean. And you're going to want to go over and check her out because she has some really interesting stuff on her channel that she deals with her condition, which is different than mine. But today's topic is how to stay positive or choosing positivity. So make sure you subscribe to my channel, give it a thumbs up, click on the bell notification, and leave a comment down below if you are already a subscriber or a new subscriber. Because if you're an old subscriber, I love hearing that. And if you're a new subscriber, welcome to the family. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for coming on my channel, Your Canadian Blind Girl. Stay tuned to see what I have for you today. Okay, so today, I'm sorry if I'm scratching my face. I am outside and I'm actually allergic to the sun and UV rays. So when I'm outside, my skin actually feels uncomfortable. But I'm gonna save that for another video. Anyways, so today's topic, choosing positivity. Now this was a bit of a challenging topic, to be honest, because I live with multiple diagnoses on top of being blind. So there are a lot of ups and downs, and she has amazing points. So we're gonna start with her first point. So Amanda, your first point.
Hi everyone, it's Amanda Jean here with another video, and today I have three tips to give to you guys to help you stay positive. My first tip is to choose to stay positive. Now for me and my life journey, it has been a very difficult lesson to learn, but through help with family, friends, and counseling, I have chosen to stay positive with life. The more positive that you choose to be, the more easier life will be.
And I think that is amazing advice. So my first point I would have to say is talking to those who are positive influences. Sometimes we have friends who they criticize situations that we're in, and they may not be criticizing us, but they may be criticizing the situation that we're in. And that can make us discontent with the situation that we're in. I know people who the conditions that they're in, I don't like them and I don't think they're necessarily good for them. But because I cannot offer them a solution, I should not say that to them. Because what that does is that creates a attitude of discontent and frustration for them. So if I were you, I would choose to have people who are positive influence. So if you're having a day that you're just really down, you're really struggling, you're really frustrated, sometimes having a conversation with those positive people just really boosts you, right? And we're gonna go on to Amanda's second point.
My second tip is choose to set dreams and goals. No matter if they're big or small, set them and achieve them. This will help with your self-esteem and get your self-esteem up and rising, and it'll make you feel amazing about yourself. I set dreams and goals for myself daily, weekly, monthly, and even yearly, and I'm achieving my own dreams and goals, and I know you can too.
That was some really good advice. I really, really like that, Amanda. Thank you so much for sharing that. My second one is take time for you. Sometimes what we do is we fill our lives with busyness because we struggle with dealing with things, and I know I'm really, really bad at this. I used to keep myself so busy, so I did not have the time or opportunity to deal with what I needed to deal with. And in the end, that just ends up running you out. So you want to make sure you have the appropriate time set aside for yourself. You don't want to have too little time that you need to deal with things, but you also don't want to have too much time, because sometimes you'll start dwelling on negative things that you cannot change, and that just makes you more frustrated and more discouraged as a person. All right, and now to Amanda's third point.
And my third and final tip is when all else fails, put on positive music and dance. Sometimes when I'm in a slump, I just put on my favorite songs that are positive and upbeat, and I just dance like crazy. And then once the song or playlist ends, I am positive, I am pumped, and I am ready to go. I hope these tips have helped you decide to stay positive, and I will see you guys again soon. Bye.
That's a really fun one, and I do agree. I love listening to music that really inspires me. And one of the songs that really inspire me and I really enjoy is called Somebody's Praying You Through. And I really enjoy that because sometimes we need a reminder that there are people in our lives that we love. And a lot of people are behind the scenes. They pray for us and never tell us that they pray for us. And there's always going to be someone somewhere who has you on their thoughts, has you on their heart, and they're praying for you and sending you good vibes and thinking of you in a positive way. So I agree so much with her, you know, talking about positive music. My third point would be, like, if you have your faith, in my faith, you know, we have prayer, praising, preaching, you know, and participation with other Christians and other people with like faith, and you get such strength from your faith. And when you're going through a hard time, that's not the time to start thinking that it's not working, because sometimes when you're going through a challenge, it can be really hard to see God's goodness. I just have to admit that. So for me, I would say rely on your faith and friends and family. And sometimes they can give you support, especially if you ask them. Maybe you don't know how you need support. Maybe you just need a hug, or maybe you just need some positive words that day. It's okay to message someone and say, you know what? I'm having a really, really hard day today. Would you mind just giving me a pep talk? Because sometimes people want to reach out and help you. They just don't know how. So thank you so much for watching this video. Like I said, make sure you subscribe. And if you lasted the whole video, I want you to write down below that you listened to all 6 points. 3 from Amanda, 3 from me. Again, thank you so much, Amanda, for this collab. We'll be doing another video on her channel, so you're gonna wanna make sure you check that out as well. And I have some different topics coming on. Make sure you check me out on my Facebook page, Your Canadian Blind Girl, and you follow me on Twitter, because I allow my followers to vote and to give suggestions on the next topics that are coming up. So thank you so much for watching today, and I hope you have an amazing day. Bye!